dogs that were here to do my brother.
Cecile got any questions?
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 28.
God hate evil. Why God hate a certain race?
God bless y'all, bless. Hey man, we out here for our people, man. We are the battle axes of the Most High.
Won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axes, God's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axes, God's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for.
That's why we start out with this.
Brother,
that's a religion, brother.
What do you say about my nationality? I'm
black, is a color in the crayon box. Look at this poster sign. This is black. Look at your skin. What color is your skin? You talk about you guess, brother. You brown, brother. If you have any doubts in your mind, so how can we be black, brother? Black is not a nationality, brother. Can you buy a plane ticket and take it to the land of black, brother? No, you cannot. So that's what we are here to teach our people, brother. How did our forefathers come to America, brother? How do we get over here to America, us as a nation of people, the so-called blacks of her? How do we come to America, I'm asking you? Brother, you don't know how we came to America? Brother, you ain't seen some of the movies, brother. That's why we got the visuals out here for our brothers, because we know that school system ain't teaching our people a damn thing either, man. We got over here on cargo slave ships, brother. Did you know that's in the Bible, brother? This is how we know who we are according to the Bible. God put particular curses on his nation of people if we would not keep the commandments of the Bible, brother. And this is how we identify who we are according to the Bible.
That's right.
Read this in Deuteronomy 28, verse 15.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Because what is your knowledge and understanding about the Bible? Do you believe in the Bible, brother, or do you think it's a white man's book? Be honest with me, man.
Oh, yeah. I think it's like a white man's book, man.
Yeah. Because we all been taught that, brother. Yeah. We just, like our old brother, regurgitated dummies, brother. Yeah. We done just heard what we heard from the past, from rumors, and just done passed it down from generation to generation. That's but right. Let me ask you, when have you ever really read the Bible? That's the point, brother. You read through it, but do you understand it? Sister, this for you too. You and brother. Read on. I want y'all to listen to this. I want y'all to listen to this, brother. This is very important, brother. Read this.
But it shall come to pass.
This is a future prophecy Moses is giving the children of Israel. Read on up.
But it shall come to pass if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So Moses is telling the children of Israel, if we don't want to listen to the voice of the Lord thy God, what is the voice of God? What is God's voice? This Bible, brother. If we don't listen to do the things that's in this Bible, read on up.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
Some of them.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
Because if you don't read the Bible, how many commandments are there, brother? It's over 613 commandments, brother. It's a lot of commandments. It's just not 10 commandments like how we've been taught in Christianity.
Christianity is
white supremacy, brother.
It has
nothing to do with the Bible once you read it and get the proper understanding, brother. You understand that? We don't know.
In his statutes, which I command thee this day.
This day? This what?
This day.
So God's laws are in effect this day, brother.
And sister, read on up.
That all these curses.
That all these what?
That all these curses.
Transatlantic slave trade.
That all these curses.
Baby mama, baby dad.
That all these curses.
Being on the bottom of society.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Now I ask you, brother and sister,
is a curse a good or a bad thing? It's a bad thing. So God said, for breaking his law, statutes, and commandments, guess what? He was going to make bad things happen to his chosen people. Not to everybody, brother. And it lists a particular curses that only happen to one nation of people and none else, brother. Y'all follow me? So we're going to read some of these curses. Jump down to verse 16.
Verse 16, cursed shalt thou be in the city.
Read that again,
Cursed shalt thou be in the city.
It says, cursed shalt thou be in the city. Bad things was going to happen to my people in the city. What are some of the bad things to happen to our people that only happens to us and no other races of people? Getting shot down by the police. Police brutality. Staying in the slums. Staying in the ghettos. Having the worst water. You see what's going on in Flint, Michigan. Eating the worst food. None of these things don't happen to the Chinese that stay in America, because guess what? They don't dwell around us. It don't happen to the Japanese. It don't damn sure don't happen to the white man, because he's the one that's doing it to
us.
It's not even happening to the Africans, because guess what? We are not Africans. You ain't never noticed how the Africans don't even live among us. Yeah, they'll come in our communities and get our money and take it back to their place, but they don't deal with us, brother. These curses only happen to us. We don't, huh?
And cursed shalt thou be in the field.
Now, what does that mean, brother? Cursed, what fields were we cursed in as a nation of people? Think about it, man. You done seen some of them old movies. Do you know, sis?
In the fields?
In
which ones, though?
All of them.
That's a good point.
Let me give you some specifics. The cotton field. That's why we got these up here.
Yeah.
The cotton field. And then we bring it up.
The cotton field,
the corn field, all these fields, and bring it up to today. Guess what? The corporate America field. First fired, last hired. You may have the better education, but an Edomite or people of another nation can come in and take your place. You've been to talk them, and now you working for them. That makes no damn sense, brother. So these are some of the curses that the Most High God has put on us to identify who we are in the Bible, brother. Give me slave ships, brother. Give me verse 68. Because we're going to read through some of these curses. Read this. This is the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28 and verse 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships. Now, what were the children of Israel doing in the land of Egypt? Do y'all know a little bit of Bible history? What were they doing? They was in slavery. Exactly. Y'all don't see that white supremacy moving, Ten Commandments. You know, that's all whitewashed garbage, man. Because Moses was a black man. The Israelites are black men.
That's right.
You are an Israelite. So guess what? Y'all not Caucasians, man. So all that stuff was lies that they had been fed to us. We was enslaved under the Africans. It was black Negroes enslaved by black Africans, brother. Read that again.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
It says into Egypt again with ships. So Egypt means something in the Bible. Let's get Exodus chapter 20 and verse 2. And let's see what the Bible identifies Egypt as. Read this out.
Exodus chapter 20 verse 2. I am the Lord thy God, which have brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage.
Y'all catch that? What did he call the land of Egypt?
Bondage.
That's exactly right, sis. What is another name for bondage? That's right, sis. Y'all get a sister hand, man. Because that's exactly what it is, man. So now Egypt means what?
Slavery.
That's how you interpret the Bible, precept upon precept. We go to another scripture to tell you what this scripture means. So now let's go back since we got the understanding. Read this from the top.
And the Lord shall bring thee into slavery again with ships. With ships.
Transatlantic slave trade.
With ships.
Being packed on that boat like sardine.
With ships.
Who is the only race of people to go into slavery on slave ships, brother and sister? We are. So this curse, this is another curse that identifies with us and us only. Your brothers, y'all come over here too, because this is a very important history lesson, man. Oh, yeah, y'all sure got to come up over here, man. Read this again.
And the Lord shall bring thee into slavery again with ships.
Now, young brothers, who is the only race of people to go into slavery on slave ships? Blacks. So this Bible is identifying the real Hebrew Israelites by the curses in the Bible.
Read on, by the way whereof I spake unto thee.
The same way Moses said it was going to happen, it happened, brothers. That's why we got these visuals out here. They packed us on that boat, brother. This was a prophecy thousands of years ago that came to pass in 1619, brother. That's how we know that the Bible is a true book. Can't no white man, no matter how powerful he is, write something, brother, in the past, and it come to pass thousands of years later. Can't nobody do that but the Most High God. Read on up.
Thou shalt see it no more again.
And we want to go see our homeland no more again. What's the motherland? Where we from, brothers? Where we from? That's what we've been talking. Say it again. Say it again, young brother. Jerusalem. That young brother knows some stuff, man. I hope you up in that Sunday church falling asleep like I was, brother. Because they ain't teaching our people not a damn thing up in there, man. All praises, you know that. How you know that, brother? All praises, man. All praises. I get that for the brother, man.
The book of Galatians, chapter 4, in verse 26. But Jerusalem, no, Africa. But
Jerusalem, which is above his feet, which is the mother of us all.
That brother, that young brother was on point, man. Israel is waking up, man, slowly but surely, man. That's why we are here, to teach our people the truth about the Bible, brother. This is how we know we the Israelites. Let's go back to the curses, man. Because what are some of the things that happened to us in slavery?
We got beat.
What are some of the things that happened to us, brothers? That's right. Guess what? We finna read it, brother. Give me verse 32. Read this out.
Verse 32. Deuteronomy 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people. And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
Jump up to verse 30 out.
Verse 30. Thou shalt betroth a wife.
Thou shalt betroth a wife. What does the word betroth mean? To marry. Read on, huh?
And another man shall lie with her.
And another man shall what?
Shall lie with her.
What is that going into, brother? If you married to a woman and another man lie with her, what is that? That too. What did you say at first? Rape, brother. That's what that's going into. That's the one of the curses that befell our sisters in slavery, just like what you said. Getting our sons and daughters taken from him. Guess what? That young daughter was pretty. Slave master could have her any way that he wanted to. Read that again, huh?
Verse 30. Thou shalt betroth a wife, and another man shall lie with her.
Read on, huh?
Thou shalt build an house.
Thou shalt what?
Build an house.
Who built the White House? Who built the White House? Do y'all know any history? Who made the White House? Who? Black people. But do we live in that house to push power in that house? Read that again, huh?
Thou shalt build an house, and thou shalt not dwell therein.
And guess what? Our people don't dwell therein unless it's the butler, just like on that movie, the butler. That's all that we could ever be up in that house. Because guess what? Obama was not our people. Right. Y'all know that? He was an African. Yeah. We are Israelites.
Bring it out.
They are Hamitic. We are Shemitic.
Teach up.
There's a two total different things from us. We come from the son of Shem. They come from the son of Ham. But they always taught us that what? Ham was cursed. He was cursed with black skin. No, all Noah's sons was black. Even Noah, brother. Read on, huh?
Thou shalt plant a vineyard.
Thou shalt what?
Thou shalt plant a vineyard.
When we was in the cotton fields, in the plantation fields, we was planting all that stuff, but was we reaping the benefits of that? No, we was not. Exactly, brother. We don't know.
And thou shalt not gather the grapes thereof.
Guess what? If the Junebug touched one of them grapes in the cotton field, guess what he got? Probably 10 or 5 lashes. Or probably got his hand cut off. They didn't have no pity on the old or the young. Just like they do us today. Y'all done heard about Tamir Rice? Brother, 10 years old, getting shot down by the police playing in front of his home, man. That makes no damn sense. That lets you know that we are for a curse.
Oh, we're on the side.
Read on, huh?
Yeah. Thine ox shall be slain before thine ox. And thou shalt not ever, therefore, thine head shall not violate.
Read verse 30. Jump down to verse 32.
32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Sister, brother, whose sons and daughters given unto another people? Ours in slavery. That's why they got these movies out here, 12 Years a Slave. Roots out here to show you, to remind you, brothers and sisters, that guess what? That happened to our people. Because did the white man go into slavery? Did the Chinese man go into slavery? Did the Arab man go into slavery? So who is this Bible? How can this be a white man's book when none of this stuff didn't happen to the white man, brother?
Yeah, right.
That's what we're trying to get our brothers and sisters to understand. Give me Jeremiah chapter 14, verse 2. Because if this is a white man's book, what is this scripture doing here, right here? I know this is going to shock you right here, brother. Read this out.
14 to 2. The book of Jeremiah, chapter 14, and verse 2. Judah mourning.
Judah is the head tribe of the southern tribe of Israel. We are the so-called blacks today. We are the leaders of the southern tribe. It says Judah mourning. Ain't we in mourning right now? On the bottom of society, man. Police brutality. Staying in the slums, in the ghettos, brother. Don't have good quality education. Calling ourselves baby mama, baby daddies, man. No other race of people does that but us, man.
Teach
those
up.
Are curses according to the Bible, man. We're not supposed to be living like this, man. We are the kings and princes of the earth, man. Sister, you are a princess. Read on, huh?
To the morning. And the gates thereof language.
Gates meaning the leaders. Our leadership is lacking. We have no leadership.
That's right.
Read on, huh?
They are black.
No,
No, they are white.
They are black.
No, black ain't in the Bible.
They are black.
We don't
know. Unto the ground.
So if this is a white man's book, what is that doing up in there? Don't you think if this was a white man's book, that would be Judah is white unto the ground?
Bring it up.
Makes no damn sense, because black is referring to the ground. The deeper you dig, the blacker it gets. That's why we got different shades of brown out here, brother. You understand that? So is this a white man's book?
Nope.
Say it again, brother. Nope. You still don't believe? We're going to give you some luck. Give me Psalms of Solomon. We don't have.
This is Exodus, chapter 4, verse 4.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord said unto Moses, put forth thine hand and take it by the tail.
Read that again, huh?
Put forth thine hand and take it by the tail.
Sit down.
And put forth his hand and caught it.
Uh-huh.
And it became a rod in his hand.
Uh-huh.
Jump up to verse 6.
Six. And the Lord said furthermore unto him, put now thine hand into thy bosom.
Because Moses wanted to know. Yeah, Moses wanted to know if God was real. So God told him to put his hand forth in his bosom like the brother did.
Read on, huh? And he put his hand unto his bosom.
In his shirt. Read on, huh?
And when he looked, took it out, behold, his hand was leprous as snow.
Brothers, y'all got to pay attention, brother and sister. So Moses put his hand in his bosom like the brother did. And when he took it out, it was leprous, white as snow. Read on, huh?
Verse 7, and he said, put thine hand unto thy bosom again.
So he put his hand back in his shirt again. Read on, huh?
And he put his hand into the bosom again,
uh-huh,
and plucked it out of his bosom. Uh-huh. And behold, it turned back again as his other flesh.
Which was what color, sis? Black, brown, sis. So if he stuck his hand and it came out white and put it back and it came back to its original color, he was a so-called brown man, according to the Bible. That's how we know that we have been taught lies, because that's how we have learned. The so-called white men have taught us everything. Do you think the people that brought us over here on slavery would teach you any truths? No, they will not. Even in our school system, history class, religion, all these things are lies. Brother, you believe in the Bible? Do you believe we got to do the things that's in the Bible? Because a lot of times Christianity, they don't want to get no. They want to just walk into the kingdom without putting in no work, man. But the Bible is all about putting in work, man. You got to be doing something for the Most High God, man. You understand that? Give me verse 46 in Deuteronomy. Give me, read this right quick. Brother, I want you to listen to this right quick, too. Because we gave you another good point that you didn't pay attention to.
Read this.
Son of Solomon, chapter 1, verse 5.
Start at 1, verse 1.
Then jump down.
Chapter 1, verse 1.
Got it.
The song of songs, which is Solomon.
It says the song of songs, which is Solomon. So Solomon wrote the songs of Solomon. Read on, huh?
Jump down to verse 5.
Verse 5. I am black.
Read that again, huh?
I am black.
No, King Solomon is white.
I am black.
King Solomon white.
I am black.
King Solomon has let you know he is black, brother. Read on, huh?
But comely.
What does the word comely mean, brothers? Do y'all know? The word comely means beautiful. What races of people say I'm black and beautiful? We do, brother. King Solomon is letting you know this is our history, brother. They saying the same words back then that we say today, brother. Read that again.
I am black, but comely. O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of cedar.
As the tents of Kedar.
Kedar.
Kedar is a son of Ishmael, the so-called Ishmaelites, which was a very dark-skinned people. He is letting you know he is compared to them in skin color. We're not the same race.
That's
people,
right.
But we're the same color. Because the original Arabs were a dark-skinned people, brother. You understand that? Let's go back to the curses, brother. Give me verse 46. Read this out.
Verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
The curses in Deuteronomy shall be upon us for a sign and a wonder, brother. What does the sign do, brother? When I'm looking at this sign right here, that sign lets me know that what? That is what? That too, but I'm talking about this O'Reilly sign. That lets me know that that's what?
Oh, okay. Oh,
right. It's O'Reilly's. It's an auto parts store. So when we read the curses in the Bible, they let us know what? Read this again.
And they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder.
The curses in Deuteronomy are upon us for a sign. A sign identifies something.
So when we read the curses in Deuteronomy chapter 15 through 68, they identify who the real Israelites are, brother. Whoever going through those curses, that's who God's chosen people is, brother. You understand that? Read this out.
And upon thy feet forever, because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart.
Because our people don't want to serve the Most High God with joyfulness and with gladness of heart. That's why he put us in this captivity. All of the Sabbath days, all of the new moon, they wanted to make money, man. They didn't give a damn about God's laws, man. But the Israelites, man, we love keeping God's Sabbath, man.
A lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's weapons of war. We won a lot of battles, but there's more in store. If you're gonna be a soldier, know what you're fighting for. We the battle axis, God's
weapons. Chapter 14, verse 2. Uh-huh. Bring it out. Mourning, and the gates thereof languish.
He said the real Jews are in mourning. And the gates, they ain't got no gates right now. We ain't got no protection.
They are black.
They are what?
They are black.
Now, the so-called white man wrote this Bible.
They are black.
If the so-called white man wrote this Bible and steps on it, they would have took out that the real